Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Heather Majors. In today's video, I am going to answer a question that one of my coworkers submitted to me about my editing process. They had seen one of my videos where I had used a sketch animation that moved across the screen and resized as necessary. When they tried to recreate this, they ended up getting the square redrawing itself every single time. In order to make this effect work, you need two different pieces. You need the sketch annotation and you need a custom animation. So let's jump on the computer and see how that works. The first thing that we need to do is go to the annotation section and then navigate to the sketch motion callouts. My favorite is the square sketch motion. And notice that there's a little star here that marks it as a favorite. I suggest that if you have a specific element that you use frequently, that you make it a favorite so that it's easier to find later instead of having to click through so many menus. Next, we will go to the animations menu item, which will default to the zoom and pan tab. We need to select the animations tab itself so that we can look at the custom animation. And notice that I have also made this a favorite. Now if I navigate to my favorites tab, you can see the custom animation and the square sketch annotation in the same place so that it will be easier to add them to the timeline. The first thing that we need to do is grab the square sketch annotation and drag it down to the timeline above the footage that we want to modify. Next, I'm going to take the sketch motion annotation and drag it across the timeline so that the annotation ends at the same time as the footage I want to modify. In order to place the square where I want it, I personally find it easier to move the playhead until the sketch is completely drawn out, and then I can position it where I want it to go. In this case, I want it to start over the Home tab, so I'm going to position it there, and then I'm going to navigate over to the Properties pane. Select the annotation marker, and then under the thickness, I'm going to up it to 8 because I feel like the square is a little bit too small. Now I'm going to scrub through the footage by dragging my playhead across so that I can quickly scan for where I'm talking about the Insert tab so that I can then move the square to that location. If you simply move the square from Home to Insert without adding the custom animation, when you play it back, it will look as if the square was always drawn over the Insert tab. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my square back to the Home tab where I originally wanted it. And then I'm going to go to the Favorites section and grab my custom animation. And then I'm going to place it on the timeline where I want the change to happen. Make sure that you highlight the arrow for the animation before you make any changes and that the playhead is at the end of the animation arrow. Now that I have the square in place, if I play it back, you can see that the square moves from the Home tab to the Insert tab as I intended. And then we will repeat the process and move the square from tab to tab until we have highlighted all of the things that we wanted to in this specific instance. Another tip that I would like to provide that is related to these animations is the length of the arrow will determine how quickly the movement happens. Now you notice on the screen I am drawing out the arrow for this animation. And that's because when I first drew it, it was quickly moving from one place to the other and it felt very abrupt. So therefore, I made the animation take a little bit longer to happen to give people time to process what was happening on the screen.